Hello and welcome. In today's video, I will be explaining the first of the features on the ibisPaint X toolbar, which is the transform function. Transform can be found on the left panel on tablets and under this button on cellular devices. It can also be found in the layers panel. This is a very helpful feature for digital artists and is, in my opinion, one of the best things about digital art that really sets it apart from traditional paper art. You'll notice that there are three tabs: Translate Scale, Perspective Form, and Mesh Form. Each has different useful abilities that I will be explaining. Immediately, you'll notice that you can now move around whatever elements are on your layer currently. Remember that you can only impact the things on your current layer. If you don't quite understand what layers are, I do have a video that you'll want to check out. If you want to edit your entire canvas, not just a single layer, scroll down here and under Target, you can select Canvas. Now, any edits you do will affect the entire canvas. There are three main things you can do under the Translate Scale tab. First is moving around the elements, as we've already seen. The second function is changing the size by pinching or pulling your fingers apart. Thirdly, if you click this button here, you can rotate the element. Remember that you can toggle both these buttons on and off, which can be very useful if you want to rotate your drawing but not resize it, things like that. These functions can be very helpful for repositioning things rather than having to completely redraw them. There are also bars here which you can use to edit more precisely, but I prefer to just edit by pinching or moving around my artwork manually. By clicking on Repeat, you can create a tiled repetition of your artwork. This can be good for making patterns. The final feature under this tab is Show Frame Around Object, which really just comes down to your personal preference. At any point in this process, if you want to save your editing, tap on the green check mark. If you want to undo and move on, click on the red X. The next tab is Perspective Form. This is similar to the Translate Scale tab because you can move it around and resize it, but you'll notice now you can stretch or squish your work as well. You can change the perspective by dragging the corners. This could be helpful if you're drawing a scene and want to make a poster for a wall or a book cover on someone's shelf, things like that. You can also repeat like the prior tab, but unlike the prior tab, these repeats will also stretch or squish. Inner will have it repeat within your frame. Horizon will have them repeat forever along the horizon, and full will repeat forever on both sides. The interpolation button down here will make it so the faraway parts are blurry. If you toggle it off, they will look sharper and therefore more static-like. Once again, you can select if you're editing just this layer or the whole canvas. Finally, we have the Mesh Form tab. This feature essentially liquefies your drawing, and you really have full control when moving around your work. I've used this feature mostly for patterns or designs on clothing. I'll draw my design and then use the Mesh Form feature to curve the patterns onto their body in the realistic way clothes would curve. Here are some examples of it from my art. As you can see, I really like drawing plaid. As you're doing this, if you want a more precise process, you can add more divisions. Smoothness controls how smoothly the art will curve around the grids you've formed. And once again, we can repeat our work, and this time it will follow the curves that we have created. Interpolation will again affect if the details are sharp or blurred. And with that, we have completed my thorough tutorial on the transformation function. For explanations of all the features on the ibisPaint X toolbar, check out my playlist. Please let me know if you have any questions about this feature or any other features at all. Thanks for watching. Have a wonderful day.